connection. I mean the cable connection, not the oil pump.
No, that's not the problem.
Sorry, we're having trouble getting the boss character out. Hold on a second, please. Hey, we got another customer waiting here. Hurry up.
Try turning on the switch again.
Okay, here goes.
Nah, nothing doing.
This is gonna be a nightmare. You over there, go ahead and jump into it and keep going. I'll try to get it to work from here.
Right, so now it's time to do battle with a crazy tree robot. And as we can see, it is the owner of the appendage that we saw before. Now, the way to fight this boss is every time he swings at you with his appendages like so, you have to dodge. Timing can be a little tricky, and you kind of have to dodge in the right direction. Right, sometimes he vomits on you as well, he does that. So basically it's, use the dodge move, swing, use the dodge move, swing, and if you can get it right, you won't get hit back. But again, you kind of have to dodge in the right direction. It's possible to dodge right into his appendages. So anyways, this would be the 800-year-old tree that swallowed George McLaughlin at the beginning. His face does look like McLaughlin's, though, so perhaps he and McLaughlin merged into this amalgamation of a human-hating lumberjack, logging mill-owning tree with a mustache. And as you can see, Michelle's taking a beating here. Almost out of health, and the bleeding is considerable. So, that's that, I guess? Well, not quite, because remember what I said a while back, that if you only have a little bit of health left, bleeding can take off the rest of it? Yeah. However, we do have the Mary doll. Yes, by sacrificing the Mary doll, Michelle will come back to life. However, she'll come back to life right before the boss battle. So, let's try that again.
There is unrest in the forest. There is trouble with the trees. For the maples want more sunlight and the oaks ignore their
trouble with the maple.
So we did a little bit better there. Not that much. Again, it's a pretty tricky battle to get the timing down right. I've never been able to get it quite right. Now, will Michelle be able to make it to the exit before her health expires? Well, no. Because the exit of this level is pretty far away. They make you go a pretty good distance. And I guess it's for this particular reason. So if you're nearly dead after fighting a McLaughlin tree, then you're not going to make it. And we don't make it here. So we don't have another Mary doll, which means we have to pick up with another character. And so this is why I've been buffing up Eriko as the backup.
Uh-huh.
Because if I couldn't get it done with Michelle, then I'm going to get it done with Eriko. And that'll do it, because as we can see, Eriko's bleeding is a lot less than Michelle's was, and that is the result of all of that upgrading. Now, as I said, I guess the tree had merged with McLaughlin. It sounded like the tree was starting to give his story when he was retracting into the ground, which I assume was meant to be heard when he was coming up out of the ground, but we did not hear it because he was malfunctioning. So the climax of this story will forever be hidden from us, but at least we can say goodbye to the McLaughlin Lumber Mill and the Wood Puppets, because we're done with this level. Yeah! And Eriko takes the fame that Michelle earned. Lost a little bit of money, but that's okay, because we have $114,000 as prize money. So that's going to pay, or rather I should say would pay, for a lot of upgrades. If it wasn't for that, we now have to bring Michelle back to life. And operations to bring people back to life are expensive. How expensive? Well, we're about to find out. Yeah, so that costs $75,000. So that's a lot of money that we have to blow on this. Right, so after doing that, now let's see how much we have left for upgrades. A couple of blood upgrades for Eriko, and that's all. But looking on the bright side, all of Eriko's friends are rescued now. Wonderful. Except not. There's actually one more friend we can rescue who was not in the intro of the game, because Eriko has not met him yet. But we will be meeting him later on. And the game sort of throws you a curveball here because they don't tell you that there is another rescuable character. But as for right now, it's time to enter Shakatomi Theater for our next attraction, the Killer Department Store. And this is the longest level in the game. I think it's the hardest level of the game in the game as well. And we're going to be doing it with the most inappropriate character to do it with, that being Randy. And I'll be explaining why next time. The prize money sign is wrong once again, but I think you already know that by now. So we will be entering the Killer Department store next time on Let's Play ILLBLEED.